Así que empecemos el show, nada más y nada menos que con María Sharapova, embajadora mundial de Porsche aquí en Miami en el Sony Open.
Well, Maria, thank you very much for taking time. You know, this is one of the busiest weeks of the of your time here in Miami for the tennis tournament. But you are the ambassador for Porsche, but you didn't just like sign a contract. You actually won a car before you signed off this contract, right?
I did. I was playing the Porsche Grand Prix in Stuttgart, and for the first time in my career, actually, a couple of years ago, and I got to drive away with a new car, and it is still a car that I drive today.
Really? That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, and it was, you know, it's obviously very symbolic when you're able to take something home like that after winning a tournament and still have it, because you always think of that memory.
Yeah.
And little by little, I got to know the Porsche family, and it's been great to be able to work with them professionally and be the ambassador for the brand.
Yeah, so I guess that was like a very easy transition, because you already were driving a car that you love, I guess.
I feel that that's extremely important when starting a relationship like that, because getting to know the people and the brand itself and the people that you know, the people that are involved, from the CEO to the owners, and I had a great relationship with them. So it's nice to know, because you know, you have to know what you expect from each other.
Yeah.
And in the partnership, knowing that time is very valuable because of my travels and what
exactly
I do in my profession, and so, but it's been great so
yeah,
far.
And it's an authentic relationship, like really truth. Like again, like you love the car, you still drive it. So
I drive the car every day. And
but
I
grew up here in Florida, right?
Yes.
So you learned to drive here in Florida, I guess?
I drove in a parking lot in a mall in Florida.
Not very challenging.
No, it wasn't very challenging.
Like
no, then I moved up when I got busy, and then I got on the roads, and
So I guess you've driven it in Germany in the Autobahn?
I have
that experience.
And I've been driven in it too, which is usually faster, because I'm always on the safer side, and it's usually the drivers that are, can we push it a little bit? I'm like, sure, I'm just the passenger.
Yeah. What impresses you most of these cars? Because obviously there's like two things of these cars. They are obviously very luxury,
mm-hmm.
but they're also like high performance. I drove the hybrid, for example, today. I was amazed by the technology.
Yeah.
But also you have to be amazed by the performance and the luxury and the details. I mean, there's like so many things, right?
There are a lot of things. And I think one of them is, you know, Porsche as a 911, and I think over the years it's been great to see the history of the 911 come into something like the Panamera and come into something like the Cayenne and going to the Macan, and to see the futures of what the brand stands for, and because that's never an easy transition, and they've been able to take all the details that have been so popular and acknowledged for so many years and bring it into these great cars.
Yeah, so there was some controversy when they launched first the Cayenne, that some people said, oh, this is not a Porsche.
Of course,
but it is a Porsche, right?
Of course. And now how many Cayennes do you see? It's
all over the place. Yeah,
exactly.
So being here in Miami, I guess you don't have too much time to drive the cars. You're like concentrating on the tournament.
Yes. And I still drive the car to the tournament.
Oh yeah,
my Cayenne. Yes.
Oh, that's nice. So what's your favorite city to drive? I guess Germany, I guess, because you can go as fast as you can.
Yeah, I do. I love to drive in Germany. It's great to have that, a bit of freedom once in a while, of course, and especially when you have the, you know, the speed of a Porsche. You want to use it. You want to be able to experience the ultimate. And, you know, besides a track, it's probably where you can actually feel all the details of the car.
Yeah. And being you an ambassador for Porsche and also for, like, a role model for so many young people in the world, I mean, obviously, you can, as you said, you can enjoy the car a little bit, but there's responsibility behind that, right?
Of course. Well, I think, you know, we always, as human beings, we have responsibilities in this world. And, you know, safety always comes first, especially when it comes to driving and paying attention to the road and not on any mobile devices and things like that. It's always a very sensitive issue. And, of course, it's an incredible experience when you're driving a Porsche, but safety does always come first.
Yeah, and that they have a lot of that, too. So
yes,
you can
they
feel
do.
Safe in a Porsche.
Right.
Well, Maria, thank you very much for your
thank
time.
You.
I know you're super busy,
thanks.
But I really appreciate
thank
the opportunity. Thank you.
Of course.
Wow, increíble la experiencia ahí con María Sharapova. Gracias a Cristina Schieber, Antonella Domasi, Lindsay Warner del grupo de Porsche de Relaciones Públicas aquí en Estados Unidos y Latinoamérica, por una velada realmente espectacular que compartimos ahí en el Sand Ridges en Bal Harbour con María Sharapova.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.